the spirit of Detroit.
Hey, all the champions out there feel so good. Hey, I said it feels so good.
Tube. What's going on? Like, comment, subscribe for more thought-provoking content like this. I'm your host, Avery Giovanni, and we gotta get into this, man, because this has become a constant theme, and it's really upsetting. I mean, for most Detroit Lions fans, we're used to being kind of put down. But Penei Sewell's performances in two preseason games have been lackluster, to say the most. Now, he did have positive play in sometimes, but when it was negative, it was very negative. And I think as an offensive lineman, you know, it's the most offensive lineman is the most thankless position in the whole entire league. You're not scoring any points. You're not running with the ball. You're not doing anything. And usually people don't even know you're there until you're not there, until you don't show up, until you make a mistake. And that's when people know your name and your number. And more often than not, you know, you had guys like Logan Stenberg. Dan Skipper supposedly had a good game. I didn't see it with the holding penalty and stuff like that. But you have individuals making follies and making mistakes. But more consistently, and I'm going to put some stuff on the screen. More consistently, we have Penei Sewell making mistakes consistently. The first mistake or the first sack was against Rousseau in the Bills game. And Rousseau is a very good pass rusher. You know, Sewell was not known for blocking out the pass. He was known for being a running mauler. That's what he was known for. That's pretty much it. He had the best feet in the draft, if not the best power, speed to power motion. We kind of knew this. And the people that, you know, reviewed him and did draft profiles, they always said, you know, I mean, you can look at it. I'll put some links down below. They always kind of said when it came to the pass, he was more finesse and he was more laissez-faire, and he would, you know, he would play through the motions. He would just have to have good technique. And it really got me thinking. This reminded me of now his comparison, NFL comparison, from Chris Sims, who is the best evaluator of talent. Fuck all them other people you heard of. Chris Sims, quarterback. He was like, this is Andrew Whitworth. And I'm like, Andrew Whitworth? We need money now? No. This dude by far is, to me, like Eric Fisher that first year. Eric Fisher came out in the league, first pick overall in 2013 draft, and he was not good his first year. Matter of fact, they initiated him as a left tackle, and by the next year, he became a right tackle. And then obviously move back, things like that. But Sewell's struggles will continue. This is kind of normal. One, you're coming off an opt-out season. Two, you're learning similar to a new position. I would say adjacent to a new position. So the struggles are going to be there. But against guys like Melvin Ingram, you don't have to make them look like Bud Dupree. I didn't know for the Steelers Bud Dupree was still on the team. I had to look it up, you know, and I knew he signed the contracts elsewhere, and it was weird because he had Melvin Ingram looking like Bud Dupree. He had Gregory Rousseau looking, you know, similar to, you know, LT or something like that. So I wasn't impressed with his showing. I wasn't impressed with the outing, but the struggles will continue, and that's a part of learning. That's a part of growing. In this league, you're not going to be great immediately. Matter of fact, it's it took 3 years for Eric Fisher to become a full-time Pro Bowler. He went to Pro Bowl in 2016. But that 2 years of struggle, that 2 years of, you know, vitriol, it was there, you know, from day one. The bad film, the bad tape, he's a bust. It was everywhere, and he was much maligned. And, you know, now he's been up until this point, up until last season where he got hurt in the Super Bowl, before the Super Bowl, he was phenomenal, you know. I can't find any bad tape, film, bad expressions on him. I actually had to dig deep and type in 2013 articles about him and fan reaction to him, because he was met with so much vitriol, so much hate, because he was bad. There's going to be a part two to this. You know, there's going to be a part two, maybe even a three. I need a whole season to look at Sewell. Just know I'm looking. And I'm going to juxtapose him to the other late round picks, or the other picks of this year, like Darisaw, Slater, what's the other one? Leatherwood. Compare him to all the tackles that came out first round. And we're going to go from there. I'm going to start a film study on him and just pay more attention. Now, like I said, I think he's a rookie. He needs time. He needs time to develop. He needs time to build a skill set. He needs time to have tools in his toolbox. It needs time. To me, at worst, and I said this on Micro Mike's channel for the draft live, where we had like 300 people. Shout out to y'all. I said this on that channel. I said, at worst, he is a guard. You know, at worst, he is a left or right guard in the NFL. And you can equate that to the short arms. You could equate that to the lack of get off. But he is a mauler, a run defender. And that's what he is. And his struggles in the pass game, you know, his struggles in the pass game are concerning. But like I say again, we need more tape on him. We actually need consistent play. So I'm going to be watching him really close. Another thing I want to make apparent is you had players like Mandarich. You have players like, I want to say, Robert Gallery, who were big, massive, very physical right tackles, left tackles, and they had to go in the guard, and that's okay, you know. So before I say all that, we're going to do the film study. We're going to go in. I would love to do it with Luke G. I would love to do it with Micro Mike. Look at this player in particular, and see what's going on, and see what the problem is. Is it fixable? Is it coachable? Because to me, it's just a lack of aggression and more thinking on the offensive end, or the pass protection end. And he doesn't need to be a person that is constantly thinking and thinking and thinking, you know. So we'll go in and see that. I would love to work with Jackson Kruger Sports. Love to work with Luke G on this. This is going to be definitely in depth. It's definitely going to be a series of grading the rookies throughout the year. Maybe probably, you know, every 4 weeks I'm looking at Sewell or whoever. So like, comment, subscribe. Tell me if you want to see this. Tell me if you want to see that segment, rather. And, you know, Sewell needs time. You know, that's my closing point. So for more thought-provoking content like this, like, comment, subscribe. I'm your host, Avery Giovanni. This is Spirit of Detroit Podcast. Love y'all.